Hello people, in this video let us look at cholecystitis. Means cholecystitis, itis is what? Inflammation, right? So cholecystitis is inflammation of the gallbladder. Okay, so basically this is the gallbladder and this will get inflamed, it will become big size. So this is cholecystitis. So the inflammation of the gallbladder, it may be acute condition, chronic condition, etc. Okay, so two things you remember, it can be acute or chronic. So acute means suddenly it will enlarge, right? Suddenly it will get inflamed. So that is cholecystitis. Okay. So today we will look at cholecystitis. So what is it? It is inflammation. You have got this word of what? Of the gallbladder. So basically acute cholecystitis is a surgical emergency, they are saying. Okay. Chronic is very common. That means long term it is inflamed. That is very common. But acute, if it gets inflamed, then that could be a surgical emergency. So acute cholecystitis, it's clinically similar to acute appendicitis, they are saying. Okay, it will begin with the obstruction and then it will get infected. So it will be acute, right, because of infection. Why it got infected? Probably because of this obstruction. Chronic cholecystitis is because of gallstones. So over the time these stones accumulate, and this is a complication of the gallstones, chronic cholecystitis. So basically, the clinical features they are saying of chronic cholecystitis. So acute, they told you, it will mimic an acute appendicitis. It is going to be a emergency, surgical emergency. Patients of chronic cholecystitis, we are talking about chronic here, chronic cholecystitis. The patients of chronic cholecystitis, they will be like fat. They will be fat, they will be fertile, they will be female, 40 or 50. So all Fs here, fat, fertile, female, hold on. So fat, fertile, female, 40 or 50, she will have abdomen is distended and epigastric discomfort will be there. So this will be the clinical feature for what? Chronic cholecystitis. Acute will mimic acute appendicitis. It's a surgical emergency. Let us look at acute cholecystitis in detail. Callus is where there is stone, right? So basically there is stone obstruction, etc. And there will be infection because of E. coli and Streptococcus faecalis probably, okay? This could be the bacteria. First of all, obstruction will be there. There will be gallstone. Remember, gallstone will be there. Usual place is Hartmann's pouch. There will be an obstruction because of the gallstone leading to bacterial infection. Then acallus, there will be no gallstone, but there will be some trauma or some recent childbirth. So some injury, some burn can be there. Diabetes mellitus can be there. Okay. So look at this. So you have seen two types of acute cholecystitis. Now let's move on to the gross and microscopy. Gross, what will you see? The gallbladder, how it will be? What do you think? The gallbladder will have some, it can have stones, correct? So let's say this is gallbladder. Let's take a green color. So gallbladder, let's draw the gallbladder. So let's say this is the gallbladder. So basically there can be stones, and the gallbladder will be distended, right? It will become big, it's tense. It can be coated with fibrinous exudate. There can be congestion here. There can be hemorrhage, right? There can be congestion. There can be hemorrhage. The mucosa is going to be bright red. Inside what will be there? Pus can be there, right? Give us some pus. Pus can be there. And bile can be there. Bile will be what? Green. So bile will be there. Pus will be there. Empyema of gallbladder can happen. So because of this pus, there can be empyema of gallbladder. Okay. Now moving on to microscopy. Microscopy, what will you see? The wall of the gallbladder shows it's an inflammation. So definitely you will see inflammatory edema, congestion, neutrophils you will see. Standard, right? So they're calling it as gangrenous cholecystitis. Okay. Now let's move on to chronic cholecystitis. What will you see in chronic cholecystitis? Basically, this is because of stones, right? This you have understood. It's a long-standing condition. The gallbladder will usually be contracted. The wall of the gallbladder is thick because we already saw that photo weight. You have seen here that the wall of the gallbladder is thick, right? And the cut section wall, you will see gray white, standard things you will write, dense fibrosis, calcification. They're talking a lot about this fibrosis and calcification, thickening they're talking a lot about here. The mucosal folds may be intact, thickened, flattened, atrophied, okay? And what will be there inside the gallbladder? Lumen. There'll be a lot of gallstones, right? There can be mixed stone, combined stones can be there, okay? Here what is shown? Here a cholesterol stone is shown, right? Solitary, oval, large cholesterol stone. You can see the gallbladder is thickened. Histologically, what will you see basically? Histologically, look at this diagram that we have drawn, microscopy, what will you see? Basically, there is something as roti Rokitansky Ashoff sinus, is it? Rokitansky Ashoff sinus. Ashoff you have also seen in the rheumatic fever in the heart, right? Ashoff bodies, Ashoff nodules. Here the same word, but it's a different thing. Rokitansky Ashoff sinus, they're calling it as the sinus, which is deep here, okay? So because this is chronic cholecystitis, the mucosa is lined by tall columnar epithelium. Remember, tall columnar epithelium you have to draw here. Mononuclear inflammatory material they are showing here. Lot of mononuclear cells are there. Hypertrophied muscular layers. The muscular layer, lot of muscle, hypertrophic muscle layer. So it's going to be really thick, right? Then perimuscular fibrosis they are saying. So here you have to show some fibrosis here. Perimuscular fibrosis, okay? The mucosa is invaginating into the muscularis. The mucosa is invaginating into the muscularis. Is this much clear in the histology of chronic cholecystitis? You can see there is, it's invaginating into what? This is the mucosa. It's invaginating into this layer of muscles, right? Of the muscularis. So the muscularis layer has become really thick. It is hypertrophied muscularis layer. Okay, because it's trying, I think, hard to push the bile out, but the obstruction is there because of these stones. Lot of stones in this gallbladder, right? So mononuclear cells you can draw, monocytes, then you can draw a lot of fibrosis here. Again, here are the mononuclear cells. Here you're drawing columnar epithelium. Look at this diagram. This is actually normal gallbladder. Even in this columnar epithelium only is there. Actually, ciliated columnar epithelium, or you can see brush border columnar epithelium is there. And here you can see muscularis layer, fibromuscular layer. This is the mucosa. Mucosa is there and fibromuscular layer is there. There's no submucosa in gallbladder, okay? So you understood, right? Brush border epithelium, columnar epithelium itself is there. So in the columnar epithelium is quite normal. So that is what has been shown here also. Columnar epithelium is normal only. Look at normal gallbladder, right? This is normal gallbladder. Now look at chronic cholecystitis, okay? Chronic cholecystitis. This is how chronic cholecystitis looks like. Another microscopic view of chronic cholecystitis. So basically you should see hypertrophy of the muscles. Of the muscularis layer actually. Okay. So is this clear? So we are done with the cholecystitis in this video. So what and all we saw? We saw what exactly it means. And we saw the types, acute and chronic. We saw that it is usually in chronic cases, there will be fat, fertile female, 40-50, abdominal distension, epigastric pain. In acute, saw the gross and the microscopy. In the chronic cholecystitis, you saw what is the gross and then you saw the microscopy. This diagram you have to practice, okay? So remember to draw. What will you draw? Rokitansky Ashoff sinus. Rokitansky Ashoff sinus. Draw nice columnar epithelium. Here lot of muscles, mononuclear cells here. Okay. In this chronic cholecystitis, again there are variants, right? Glandularis, porcelain gallbladder is there. Acute on chronic cholecystitis. Interesting. So these are the variants. You can read more about them from the textbook. Okay. That's all about cholecystitis. Bye bye.